Hi there, and welcome to our SendPulse channel. Here we talk about email marketing news and ways to improve your marketing experience. In case you're about to give up trying to reach your subscribers' inbox, this video is just for you. Today we'll dive into a hot button email marketing issue – spam. So, what is spam? It is an irrelevant and undesired message that a user receives without permission. Check out what a spam message usually looks like. So, the first and most important recommendation is to build your own permission-based list, as permission-based marketing is what keeps you far from spam folders. When using a purchased, rented, scrapped, or shared mailing list, there is no way you can count on having permission from the users to send their marketing emails. On top of that, such mailing lists often contain non-existent emails, which lead to delivery issues. Mailbox providers perceive such issues as a signal to keep the campaign out of a recipient's inbox and to get the sending address or domain blacklisted. Secondly, use a double opt-in subscription form. Double opt-in is a two-step subscription process. First, a user fills in their email and second, gets a confirmation email with a link. By clicking on that link, the recipient confirms the subscription. With this method, there will be no more non-existent email addresses on the list, as only a real person using a valid email address can confirm the subscription. Alternatively, with a single opt-in in turn, some incorrectly typed email addresses may appear on the list, causing delivery errors. By the way, there is something you need to know about delivery errors. There are two types of delivery errors – soft bounces and hard bounces. Soft bounces usually happen when the recipient's inbox is full, the server is down or overloaded, or the email is too large for the recipient's inbox. Hard bounces are quite an issue, as they happen when the address or domain doesn't exist, the address contains a typo, or the address is inactive or no longer used. Be sure to track these bounces and remove them, as mailbox providers block a sender with the number of hard bounces exceeds 5%. Okay, another thing worth mentioning is sender reputation. The key mission of every mailbox provider is to deliver messages that are relevant to a user and filter out those that are not. When sorting emails into folders and blocking suspicious messages, mailbox providers are guided by sender reputation. All mailbox providers use different algorithms to calculate it. Yet, what counts for sure is the reputation of the sending IP and domain, number of spam complaints and unknown users, and the appearance of IP address on blacklists. A postmaster can help you in monitoring all these indicators. Sign up for the one provided by a mailbox provider, one that the majority of your subscribers use, or set up postmasters from different providers. Everything you need to know about postmasters is on our blog. The link is in the description below. One more point is verification of email addresses on your mailing list. Invalid email addresses can result in a high spam placement rate, especially if a sender ignores repeated delivery errors and continues to send emails to invalid recipients. Email validators can help you as a sender keep your mailing list clean. You can find the list of such validators in our blog post about spam. You'll find the link in the description below. Next, think about SPF and DKIM records. Mailbox providers use these authentication technologies to confirm the identity of the sender. If the letter cannot be authenticated, mailbox providers may reject the message or put it through additional filters to determine whether it should be delivered. Now let's talk about IP addresses. An IP address is an unidentified number listed in the domain name system. Mailbox providers check this number and its rank against other IP addresses when determining whether or not to place the incoming message in the inbox. There are two types of IP addresses. Shared IP address is used by multiple senders, which increase the sounding frequency and volume, making the address warmed up, which means more active. In this case, however, an individual sender cannot control the reputation of the address as it depends on the actions of other senders too. Dedicated IP address is used by a single sender who is fully responsible for its reputation. However, it is essential to keep any IP address warmed up. To accomplish that, send no less than 50,000 messages a month. If you have registered a new IP address and have not sent anything from it yet, warm it up gradually by sending small numbers of emails regularly. Also, make sure your IP address is not blacklisted. Any sender can check their IP address from the appearance on blacklists. The list of tools you can use to do it is available in our blog post. The link is in the description below. And finally, create content that doesn't look spammy. Mailbox providers use special spam filters that automatically identify spam inside an email. They recognize spam words in both HTML and text-based emails. To combat spam filters, don't use JavaScript. Avoid redirecting services and link shorteners. Don't ever use caps lock. Avoid spam words and phrases like sale, hot prices, buy now, and so on. Check your HTML for syntax and formatting errors, and maintain a balance between the amount of text and images. So, there you are. Proceed to our article for more tips on how to prevent emails from landing in a spam folder. The link is in the description below. Like the video, share it, subscribe to our channel, and press the bell icon to keep up with the latest marketing news. See you!